Since 1995, I have shipped thousands of buildings across North America, both the United States and Canada. So I've put together this video of 7 points to consider when shopping for a storage shed. Number one, what will be the main purpose of the building? Number two, size. What size will work the best for you? Number three, zoning and building permits. Number four, fully assembled versus DIY. Number five, budget, budget, and budget. Number six, financing and RTO. Number seven, shipping. The number one question I always ask folks when they come to me and ask me for a building project is, what do you plan on using the building for now and in the future? Allow me to give you the best guidance possible and giving you the design that will work the best by telling me how the building will be used. It will be a much different building as if you're going to close the door and walk away from the shed, using it as a closet, as opposed to going inside of the building, shutting the door behind you, and spending time inside of essentially creating a living space. Number two, size. The most common size sheds range from 8x10, 8x12, 10x14, 12x16, 12x20. Those are very common sizes that you'll see in all across the shed industry. Now, my number one complaint from folks that I have purchased buildings from us in the past is, I wish I had gotten a larger building. So size is definitely a good concern to have when shopping for a building. Number three, building permits. Now, no matter where you are, the building permits are most oftentimes regulated by your local municipality, your town clerk, building department. Check with them first. I always recommend doing that online first rather than calling them and raising a red flag. Get yourself acquainted with the laws first before approaching the building department. Oftentimes, for a smaller structure, a permit is not required. Number four, fully assembled FA versus a DIY project, do it yourself. So whether you purchase the plans and the materials separately or a kit, there are many different choices to consider when choosing a kit. Now, there are different kinds of kits to consider. PCK, which is a pre-cut kit, is a very common one where each piece is color-coded, part numbered, so it's like painting by numbers for a construction project, building by numbers. A RTA, ready to assemble, is more of a panelized situation where each piece is a section and it goes together in pieces. And finally, a DIY project would be where the plans are purchased and the material separately to be able to cut all of your own material and assemble it. Now, number five we have is budget, budget, and budget. Now, most people, what they do is they come to us and say, I have this amount of money. What can I get for this? Well, we would prefer that you take a look to see what is going to fit your intended purpose and what design will work the best. As far as the budget goes, we have lots of different choices for financing and paying over time, which brings us to number six, financing and RTO. RTO refers to an industry-wide standard that has come recently into light, which is rent to own. Now, the rent to own options go out throughout the whole industry and is available through many parts of different states in the United States as well as Canada. Rent to own is a process of financing and paying over time. Once the project is paid off, then you would own the building. Shipping. Now, the shipping considerations would be if you're going to have a building delivered to you in one piece, fully assembled, if it's going to come in on the back of a truck, consider that the building will have to go, the truck, to the site of where the building will be planted. So you don't want to be driving over any buried tanks, the leach field possibly, or stone walls, hedges, landscaping like that. So you want to be able to get that truck to the site. There is a new tool in the shed industry. It's called the shed mule. And that shed mule can bring the fully assembled project to the shed site while the shed and the truck and the trailer stay out on the main road. There are links down below, and you can take a look at that. I'll leave quite a few different links to review on some of these, to expand on some of these different considerations. The other thing about shipping is that you want to consider, if you're going to do a kit, where will that kit be dropped in your yard, and how far will that be processed to the building site? The kits can be very heavy, and can be a challenge to get those to the building site depending on how far that is. So those are some of the seven considerations that you might want to think about when shopping for a shed. Now, one of the last things I always want to say, I've replaced a lot of buildings over the years. Everything from tarp structures that have blown across the yard to metal sheds that have crushed under the weight of snow. And I've also replaced buildings that have literally rotted away. So there's a lot of different ways that you can gain the shelter and space that you're after. I hope these seven considerations help you in choosing. And I hope that you subscribe if you like this video. I have lots more that will help you in choosing the right site preparation, how to prepare the site. Also, I can help you with choosing the 3-season versus 4-season. A lot of folks come to us and choose a shed simply to live in. That has been a great situation, and a great solution for a lot of folks looking for an alternative housing situation. A tiny house living is something that we also do, and you'll see that in many of my videos. So we can help you if you call a designer. We can help you choose a 3-season, maybe a 4-season insulation package. My name is Dominic Mongano. I am the senior designer and founder of Jamaica Cottage Shop. I appreciate you watching our videos, and please subscribe.